Believe it or not, I need someone to join my gymnastics team. So I set a surprise test for some of my friends to see who is best at gymnastics. I've asked them to fetch me a cup of tea, but what they don't know is that they're going to have to pass through this obstacle course. So whoever passes the obstacle course best wins and joins my gymnastics team. Let's see how they get on. After seeing Rich's athletic ability, I had to choose him for my gymnastics team. He showed me how good he was, so I put my trust in him. In our true Bible story this morning, God's people were standing at the edge of the promised land. God has promised that this land would be theirs, but God's enemies still lived in this land. So, Joshua, who was the leader of God's people, sent two spies into one of the cities called Jericho. In Jericho, a lady called Rahab, who lived there, showed kindness to the spies and kept them safe from God's enemies. But why had Rahab been so kind to the spies? Well, Rahab said to the spies, "I have heard how powerful your God is. How he parted the Red Sea, how he helped you as you wandered in the wilderness. I know that your God is powerful, and he rules over the heavens above and the earth below. And I know that he will give you Jericho. So please promise that you will keep me and my family safe." We're going to have to wait a few weeks to find out what happened in Jericho. But you see, for Rahab, she had heard about who God was and heard about what he had done. And because she had seen that God was powerful and loving, she put her trust in him. And that's the right response, isn't it? And over 1,000 years later, Rahab's great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandson was born. His name was Jesus. And he did something even more amazing than passing the Red Sea. You see, he showed us his great love and power by dying on the cross to defeat the enemies of sin and death forever for us. And so we should respond like Rahab and put our trust in him.